we shout with the shout of victory to the King, to the King, to the King, to the King. We give you praise in Jesus' name.
This creates intimacy. And what God desires from us is intimate worship. Intimate worship attracts the favor of the King. I want you to keep saying this until you understand this, because you want to do this in your home. You want to do this in your car. What we're providing here is not something that you just want to just get here. This has got to become a lifestyle. Amen. Everybody declare, I'm a worshiper. I love Him with all of my heart, with all my mind, with all my strength. When you worship God, you attract His favor. You attract the benefits of a King when you worship Him. He loves to be worshiped. And He is a spirit who is seeking you as a spirit. He created you a spirit being first. And He said, I want you, spirit, to worship me. How? In your flesh? In your mind? Some people have a strong voice, but they don't know how to worship. Amen? God says, I want you, I don't care if you know how to go, yada doo doo doo. If you sing like a duckling, I want you to worship me with all of your heart, with all of your mind. And so together, I'm going to lead you on a song here today. The words will be on the screen as we declare, we are the house of God. Amen. We didn't come to church this morning. Everybody say, I didn't come to church. And say it again. I didn't come to church. And this is against all the religious thinking that you've had in your mind. You've grown up and you stated it out of your mouth, and out of the life and death lies where? In the power of our tongue. The power of our tongue. And we've said it so much that we've got to now recondition our thinking. Because as a man thinks, so is in. If we think we came to church, we won't be the church. We didn't come to church this morning. We are the church. God does not dwell in tents made of men's hands any longer. They used to carry around the presence of God in the Ark of the Covenant, and that's how He stayed among them, because they would not make themselves the house of God. But God desires now to dwell in you. When you go to work, when you're in your car, when you're in your neighborhood, when you're watching TV, when you're listening to the radio, God desires worship, temple, to be this right here, from the top of your head to the soles of your feet. And so as we sing this song, and we're going to make this declaration that this, put your hand on your chest, say this, shall be called the house of worship. This shall be called the house of praise. This shall be called Bethel.
As we sing together, let me ask you to raise your hands unto our God and join into intimate worship in one unified voice together as one body. Let's bless the Lord, all our soul, with all that is within us. We shall be called the house of worship. The words are on the screen. Sing along with it. Don't be a participant.
Of your righteousness. We need a touch. Touch from your grace, and here the chains must fall at the power of your word, and here the chains must fall at the power of your word,
right here and right now,
right here in this moment, the chains must fall at the power of your word, and every knee must bow and tongue confess that Jesus is Lord.
Come on, let's worship. Let's descend up our hearts unto our King this morning and declare,
and this shall be called the house of worship.
Come on, raise both hands unto our God in total surrender.
This shall be called the place of Bethel, the place where God lives. This shall be called the house of worship. This shall be called the place of praise. This shall be called the house of Bethel, the place where This shall be called the house of worship.
Come on, worship him. Worship him, saints of God. Come on.
This shall be called the place of heaven.
Press into your king this morning. Press into him. Come on, worship him. Worship him, worship him.
This shall be called the place of heaven. This shall be called the place of praise.
Come on.
This shall be called the place of man.
He is worthy of your worship.
The place where God
you are. Come on. When you don't know what else to say.
Anybody got a war cry out
to our God. Father, we give you thanks this morning. We declare your kingdom come. We declare your will be done here in our lives, here on the earth. As it is in heaven, so let it be on earth. Through these, your ambassadors, these, your representatives, these, your governing officials. Father, I pray that you will use us as we set ourselves apart, as we truly live out the lifestyle of being the called out ones. I declare this morning as a believer, as a priest and pastor over this house, I call in those who are called out. I call in those who are broken. I call in those who are downtrodden. I call in those who hunger and thirst. I declare over north, south, east, and west, marriages shall be restored in this city. Marriages shall be restored in this house. Children shall find their destiny and purpose and understand the meaning and the purpose of why they were created. And they shall live bold. They shall live pure. They shall live holy. And we as a people who once were not a people, but now we are the children of God. We are the family of God. The world shall take note that we have spent time in your presence. For in your presence is the fullness of everything we have need of. The fullness of provision, righteousness, peace, and joy. For those who walk in the Spirit shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. May this moment that we walked in spirits together right now become a private lifestyle of everyone in the sound of my voice. That we become so familiar with your presence that we become addicted. That we become so addicted to your presence that we can't live without it. When we're in the bathroom, we want your presence. When we're in the car, we want your presence. When we're driving down the road, we want your presence. When we're in the grocery store, we want your presence. For the presence of God brings the power of God. Father, it is your power that we need in this day and age. It is your power we need to demonstrate into a world what light means in the midst of darkness. To demonstrate solutions and answers, kingdom knowledge and revelation in the midst of those who have lost their way. Father, I pray that you will empower everyone who hungers and thirsts for righteousness today. Those who hunger and thirst, they shall be filled. Your word says, if we seek you, we will find you. If we seek you with all of our hearts, seek him with all of your heart this morning. Seek his will, not your will. Seek his desire, not your own desire. Seek to be pleasing to your king, not to be pleasing unto men that oppose his kingdom. Father, empower us to succeed. Unite us as one voice, as one body, serving one tremendous, holy, majestic king. We give you thanks today. We honor you with our life. Let's lift up a shout of praise unto him with one sound right now. Come on, worship your king this morning. Hallelujah! Yes! Hallelujah! We worship you, mighty God. Be exalted, be glorified today. Be magnified. Come on, worship him. 2 minutes. 2 minutes. Clap him. Come on, give him a clap. Give him a clap offering. Give him a praise offering. Give him a shout. He's worthy of our praise. He's worthy of our praise. Come on, he's worthy of our praise. Come on, 60 seconds. Worship him, worship him, worship him. Praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him. Praise him with a cymbal. Praise him with a dance. We bless you, mighty God. There is no other God beside you. We totally surrender our hearts, totally surrender our minds. And now we pray that you'll teach us what you desire for us to have revelation of, that might empower us with confidence and boldness to preach this gospel of the kingdom into the uttermost parts of the world and continue the mission that was modeled for us by our Christ. Our Lord, we bless you today. We declare your kingdom come. Say it with me. Say, your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Yeah!
Come on, we ain't finished. Come on, it ain't over. Come on, it ain't over. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, put those hands together. Come on, put them up high. let your will be done right now.
Lord, let your kingdom come right now.
Lord, let your will be done right now.
Lord, let your kingdom come right now.
Lord, let your will be done right now.
Lord, let your kingdom come right now.
Lord, let your will be done right now.
Lord, let your will be done right now.
I can't hear you out there. I cannot hear you. Now, I don't know about you, but when I drove up this morning, I believe the name still says that the Lord gave for this house is called Champion Kingdom Center. Now, number one, you're a champion. Champions always
win. To win.
We expect it and we do it.
Do it.
Isn't that right? Look at somebody. I mean, look them real good deep in the eyes and say, did you forget who you are? Look at the other person. And I said, this is what I told them, but I'm going to tell you too. Tell them what I just said. Say, did you forget who you are? Say, now I know your name is whatever the name is. But God has given you a new name. And he has given you a name by which no man can change. He has given you a name by which even the angels hearken unto. And that name is a child of the Most High God. And as children of the King, we know that what? We are his children. So therefore, we always win. Champions are strong. Look at somebody. Say, I'm strong today. Say, I'm bold today. Say, I am worrying today. Say, I'm an overcomer today. Say, I'm more than a conqueror today. Say, let me tell you this too. In case you didn't know, I'm abundantly blessed today.
Yeah! Yeah!
If you didn't know this, tell them again. Say, if you didn't know this. Say, I have angels that hearken unto the voice. So as long as I'm speaking the word, say, the angels are on the scene. They are opening up a pathway for me. Ha, they are standing beside me. Say, they war on my behalf. Say, all I've got to do is just stand there. And all I have to do is decree a thing, and it shall be established in the earth. I shall see the goodness of my God in the land of the living. Say, there is nothing that shall be able to harm me. Nothing that shall be able to overtake me. I think maybe two of you really are getting this. Do you know the power that you walk in? Oh my God. Why do you think that accident that was supposed to take place didn't? Why do you think when you went home and you left the door unlocked, nobody could go in there and steal your stuff? Okay, let me bring it in like this. Why is it that when the enemy thought he had you physically, you were sick, you were diagnosed, you were given a negative report, but today you're standing alive, whole and healed, and walking in his goodness? Why is it that when they said, if you don't make this payment, we're coming to get it? And on the way, someone came and gave a knock at your door. Someone had something in the mail. You received a ring, a little phone call. How many of you know they couldn't take it? They couldn't snatch it. They couldn't steal it. They couldn't remove it. Ooh. Don't you know that you're like Job? Remember the enemy said, he came to God and he was before his presence and he said this. The Lord asked him, he said, where have you been going? And the devil replied and said, I've been going to and fro in the earth. He's been going to and fro in the earth, To and fro means I've been going here and there. I've been going north and south, east and west. I've been going in the earth. And then the Lord threw something at him. I love this. And that's what he's doing with many of you. He's saying, have you considered my servant?
Uh-huh.
Now his name was Job. What is your name?
Yeah.
And the Lord said, Job was a man that was upright in all of his ways. Yeah. Upright. Now the Lord gave the idea to Satan to test Job. Isn't this an awesome thing to know that your God thinks that much of you?
Yeah.
That he knows that the stuff that's on the inside, that's on the deep inside, that's way down on the inside, when the going gets really tough,
yeah.
And normally the saying is the tough get going, well, guess what? You got going, but you got it in the right direction. The enemy is not able to take the strong. He is not able to take those who are mighty. He's not able to come in to deceive those who keep themselves in the will of the king. But how many of you know that after the enemy, and then he threw this back at the Lord. Ain't he stupid? Satan is just stupid. Y'all gotta say he's stupid.
He's stupid.
That's okay to say, it's stupid. He said this, yeah, I know why Job serves you. I know why Job worships you. I know why Job honors you. I know why Job keeps the word. It's because you've got this thing called a hedge all around him. And that hedge is a protection and a barrier. Nothing can get in. The enemy couldn't even get in. He knew that. So you got to remember this. As you go and as you are and as you do and as you say, there is a hedge around you. The enemy's got to go up to the Lord and ask, may I have permission to test them on your behalf?
Wow.
The enemy cannot get in unless you open the door. Some people say, what's the door? My mouth. My mind. My will. But if you keep the mind, the mouth, and the will locked up to the king, all the enemy can do is go around, go around, go around, go around. He can look. He can try. He can jiggle the door handle. He can knock on the door. He can kick it, but he can't get in. He can't get in. Woo! You got to remember this. You got to remember this. So as you're hearing these stories that are going in the airwaves about Ebola and ISIS and the economy and what's going on in Ferguson, and I could go on and on what's going on in Houston, you got to remember, nothing can get in. There is a hedge around the righteous. The Lord encamps his angels around the righteous and his seed and your children. Your children are blessed. The word declares that my seed is delivered. Somebody shout, my seed is delivered. That means those babies, those infants, those adults, those teenagers, your seed, your grandbabies, your seed is delivered. Now look at somebody and say, hey, I don't know what you've been dealing with this week, but we're in the house of the Lord. And it's time to celebrate. Say, this is the safest place that you can be all week.
Right.
Say, I know you were waiting to get here, just like me. So come on, let's celebrate. Come on, sing that one more time, that verse. Lord, let your kingdom. Come on, I want you all to put your hands together real good. I need some ladies.
Hallelujah.
Come on, I need
come
some
on.
Ladies.
Father,
come
let
on.
Your kingdom come now.
I need some ladies.
Cover the earth.
Come on, let's
cover
worship.
The earth.
Woo,
come on. Father, let your
kingdom come now.
Come now.
Cover the earth,
Lord. Father, let your kingdom come now.
Let your kingdom
come now.
Cover the earth,
Lord. Father, let your kingdom come now.
Let your kingdom come now.
Yeah.
Cover
the earth, Lord. Our Father.
Our Father. Who art in heaven.
Hallowed be.
Hallowed be your name.
Your kingdom come.
Your kingdom come.
Your will be done.
Your will be done.
On earth as it is in heaven.
All right, right there. Musicians. Musicians. I want y'all to give it to them, okay? We're going to sing this. Come on, David. Don't hold nothing back over there. Come on, ladies. Don't hold nothing back. Find yourself a partner. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Woo! Hey! Come on, come on. Come on, anybody else that wants to come? Together real good. Come on, everybody. Hey. I got a little something for you. Now, when we over in the islands, I'm going to tell you something. They don't know how to get down with no hesitation, no reservations. So I want you all to come on, put on your best island accent, man. I want you to put on your very best island groove, man. And I want you all to worship God. Come on, this is not for show, but this is to let the enemy know he has no power and no authority, that today my life belongs completely unto the King, and that the women who know how to worship are gonna lead us. The women who know how to lift their hands and they're unashamed of the gospel and of the kingdom of God. They're gonna come on. Pick your legs up, ladies, and let's go. Say one, two, one, two, three, go! Woo! That's looking real good, real good. Hey. Woo. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody, lift our hands. Father, we give you praise today, and we honor you and we thank you that we are more than victorious, that we are queens and kings in the land. Thank you for your word. Thank you for your joy and your peace. We are grateful, we are honored, and we are overjoyed that you are our God and our Lord and our King. And today we surrender our lives unto you. We say thank you, Father, for this house. We thank you for the word of God in this house. We thank you, Father, for our pastor. And we thank you for the word that is going to come forth today. May this day, this moment be a transformation. May no woman or man that walked into this place leave the way that they came. We pray for the fire of God to fall. May the Spirit of the living God be dwelling richly in this house. May the presence of the King not be dishonored or denied access. Today we say to every backslider, every individual who is seeking, you have come into the kingdom of God for such a time as this. We call you home today in Jesus' name. And we declare that the wealth of the King shall be exhibited in this place. Father, may signs, may wonders, may miracles, may healing, may deliverance take place like never before. Usher in your presence. Usher in your kingdom. Usher in your will. Today, Father, we release everything and we give it over to you. We cast every care upon you, for you careth for us. So, Father, take us in your arms. Wrap us in your arms, Father, and let us know that you are near. So today we honor you, we bless you, and we celebrate our King. Come on, everybody who agrees with that, give me a big shout. Give me a big shout. Come on. Now put your hands together. Come on, put your hands together. Hallelujah. Come on. Now I want you to look at somebody and say, keep that going all day. Say, keep that going all day. Woo! Hallelujah. Come on, you all may return to your seats and let's get ready. Hallelujah.
That's what we are.
That's what we are.
Can y'all say that with me?